87. Chapter 16. Possibilities. Driver. Catalunya Casa, Cura. You can slow down for this leg, driver, lento. Bob turns back to Ingrid, pulling her in close. We need to stop meeting like this, lady. Smiling contently as he caresses her golden locks, she drops her head into his lap. Here, Bobby, I picked an apple for you from the tree in the hotel garden. I just need a few minutes rest. We should be there in 20 or so. I see you brought tea. Good, we are going to need it. As the cab pulls away, stepping out from the shadows of the hotel arboretum came Sophie and the man in the black coat. Bob takes a bite from the fruit, then drifts off, not into a deep sleep, but into a semi-conscious dream state filled with visions of grandeur. He dreams of a place in time, a blissful and serene setting, where all seemed right with the world. A time of joy and peace, utopian in all its essence. He envisioned he was in the middle of a playful, but rough and tumble scrimmage game of football with his cousins, his friends and family. Ricky, I'm open. 88. Ricky, panning his field view, spots Teddy wide open near the end zone corner and yells out. Go left, Teddy, then launches a Hail Mary, right into the intercepting arms of another player. As the receiver turns back around, acknowledging the thunderous round of applause, Bob catches a closer glimpse of this hero's identity. It's Bobby Kennedy. Wow. I am playing football with the Kennedys right now. This must be their compound in Yarmouthport. Bob steps halfway out from behind this mirage of memories, then swan dives back down in. Jack, come on in and play, his brothers enticing him into a challenge. Go ahead, Jack, go rough it up with the boys. Jackie gleaming in the wholeness of these precious moments, sitting side by side with her knight in shining armor. All right, Jackie, just a few touchdowns should do it. Jack Kennedy, glowing in his own presence, steps out onto the field, tickling and taunting the younger spectators as they playfully cheer on the competition from the sidelines. Bob tries to slow down this action in his mind's eye, not wanting this scene to ever end, but instead felt himself being pulled up and away from this majestic setting, zooming up higher and higher, looking back down in. Rising and up, he was beginning to see the curvature of the earth in all its fullness and awe. 89. Higher than he had ever been, higher and higher he flew, like a seagull that separated from his feathered flock of contented peckers, then a sudden push sent him into a downward spiraling freefall. He felt himself being pulled back down to Mother Earth. The spirit of her maternal welcomes you back home. Falling closer and closer back to solid ground, he enters a new scene. Peering down from his suspended perch, he sees crowds of people cheering, waving, and singing. All focus was on this one individual that appeared to be the center of all their attentions. He releases his talon's grip, spreads his wings, sailing down in for a closer look, gliding overhead, above this ocean of bodies, keening in for a bird's eye view, sweeping across, closer, and closer to his intended target, arresting kinesis in mid-flight, fluttering his wings, sustaining his position, he gazes into the eyes of this hero. I have seen this man before. This is Jack Jr., the President of the United States. What time is this? The year 2030 came flashing into his foreview, like a sparkling ball of lights, dropping, falling, settling into a shiny bright metropolitan city square, announcing the end of the old and the ringing in of the new. Then in a flash, Bob felt himself being slingshotted back up into the stratosphere, up and up and up until he hit what felt like the ceiling of a colossal covered stadium. Reaching out with his left hand, he stretches to touch the celestial canopy, then he feels an equal and opposite exchange, as if a reverse magnet were pushing him back down in, as if the finger of God were not ready to receive this one soul. 90. Falling, 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 thud. Bob returns to body, back. Into the cab, back next to his fountain of love.